We can now move to a further aspect of the device, the BJT, and we'll talk about the maximum voltage readings of the bipolar junction transistor. We now say up to now we said that the wide collector region, the thick collector region, is needed to sustain the reverse voltage. And more or less, we can think of a design that is similar to what we do for a PIN diode. There are, however, important differences due to the presence of the bipolar effect into the device. We know that the collector voltage for a BJT, without taking into account the thermal instability, the maximum power dissipation, can be increased up to a maximum value that we call the breakdown voltage. But in many cases, this breakdown voltage that we measure for the bipolar junction transistor is lower than the breakdown voltage that we measure for the base collector junction. For example, if we have 50 microns of collector region with 10 to 14 doping concentration, we see that this device is able to sustain around 800-1000 volts for a PIN diode. If I design this structure for a PIN diode, I can reach, for example, 1000 volts. For a bipolar junction transistor with the same collector structure, the breakdown that we measure is not 1000, will be reduced. We will see why in a while. The actual breakdown voltage that we measure depends on the internal resistance of the base driving circuit. We can consider two extreme cases. If the driving circuit is seen as a current generator with a very high output resistance, the maximum voltage is named BVCE0. This voltage will be much lower than the maximum voltage BVCB0 that we can obtain when the driving circuit can be considered as a voltage generator with a low output resistance. This means that the output IV curve for the two cases are those that are sketched in this plot here. Here we have the output curves with the usual current drive for IB equals 0, IB1 that is larger than 0, IB2. Since we are driving the device with the current generator with a very high internal resistance, this curve will reach a breakdown that is BVCE0. If we drive the base to emitter junction with the voltage generator, in this case only the case VBE equals 0 is shown, the situation is different. The applied voltage can increase up to BVCB0 before observing the breakdown. However, in this particular case, the breakdown has a strange behavior, because we expect the breakdown characteristic going up here in a straight vertical way, but what we see is a negative differential resistance region with a characteristic that falls back and retards to this asymptote here, that is BVCE0. First, analysis. We want to calculate and analyze the case when we have BVC is zero. We have a current drive for the base. We are in the active region. The base to collector junction is reverse biased. There is a small current entering into the base, and we can say that the collector current is equal to alpha multiplied IE. Alpha is the current gain between current and emitter. Alpha is much smaller than one, very close to one, but smaller than one. Here we need to take into account the leakage current of the collector to base junction. Normally, when IC is very large, alpha IE is very large, we neglect this ICB0. But since we are considering this case, the leakage current, the collector current is small, the leakage current will be significant. Let's now consider the case of a base current that tends to zero. It's very small. The limit case for the BJT in the off state. We will have that IC0 will be equal to IE0 since the base current is zero, and will be alpha multiplied IE0 plus ICB0. We can obtain IE0 as a function of ICB0, and it is ICB0 divided 1 minus alpha. That is a very small value. The breakdown happens because we have avalanche multiplication in the collector region. In the collector region, that is reverse bias, the electric field will go to a quite high value, will be close to the critical value that we studied for the PIN diode, and then there will be avalanche multiplication. As for the PIN diode, in this case, we can say that both leakage currents, IE0 and ICB0, can be multiplied by M, that is the multiplication coefficient. We can then write that in 25, IE0, that is a function of VCE, is proportional to M multiplied ICB0 divided 1 minus alpha multiplied M. With M, for M, we can use the Miller empirical relation that says that it is 1 divided 1 minus VC divided VBR to the power of N. N is a number that goes from 2 to 6. It's clear that IE0 tends to infinity, that is the breakdown condition, if alpha multiplied by M tends to 1. We then get that the BVC0 is given by M BVC0 is equal to 1 divided alpha. We can substitute 27 in 28, and we get BBC E0 divided VBR to the power of N equal 1 minus alpha. Depending on N, that goes, let's say, from 2 to 6, the actual BVC E0 value will be from 50% to 70% of BVCB0, that is the breakdown voltage of the base to collector junction without the bipolar junction effect. In our previous example, if the collector junction for a PIN diode, the sustaining layer that used for the collector junction, implemented in a PIN diode, was able to provide 1000 volts of breakdown voltage, for a BJT we get a value that is between 700 and 500 volts. The equations here are practically telling us that the leakage current that is multiplied by m due to the multiplication, avalanche multiplication factor, is further multiplied by the bipolar effect, by the gain of the transistor. And this means that for every carrier that is multiplied in the collector region and enters into the base, there is a further injection of carriers from the emitter that goes into the collector due to, because these carriers into the base are base current. Hence, we get a lower breakdown due to the bipolar multiplication, bipolar gain, more or less. Second case, we have the calculation of BDCB0 when we use a voltage drive on the base. Assume the case with VBE equals 0. Now the situation is different, because the leakage current that comes from the collector arrives to the base, but since the base resistance, the base to emitter resistance is zero, the current just goes into the base and is not going into the emitter, causing the bipolar gain. The consequence is, in this case, there is no injection of the electrons from the emitter. It's like alpha is zero. There is no gain of the transistor. And this current is merely increased by the multiplication factor. The collector current as a function of VC will simply be M times ICB0 and will be this equation. There is an error here, the parentheses should be here, not the 1 minus is eliminated. This equation tells us that IC0 will increase to infinity only when the breakdown voltage VBR on the base collector junction is reached. Hence, with the base driving, voltage driving on the base, the breakdown voltage that we measure is exactly the same that we see for the base to collector junction. For our previous example, we get the 1000 volts that we were telling about. This value will be between 500 and 700 volts in our example, and this value will be the 1000 volts of the collector base collector junction. However, we see in this region here that there is this negative differential resistance region with the current that returns here, with the characteristic that returns here. Why? This is indicated here, introducing this resistance. What happens is that at the beginning of the breakdown, there is a small current flowing. When a small current flows, also the resistive voltage drop on this layer is small. And we remain in our ideal case with a voltage drive on the base and the emitter to base junction that is not activated at all. But when the current increases, there will be a voltage drop on this resistance. When this voltage drop is around 0.7 volts, 0.5, it depends, the central part of the emitter region starts to be forward biased and will start to inject electrons into the base. This will cause an injection of electrons in this region. They will multiply, causing an increase of other electrons injecting from here, and will activate the bipolar transistor. This means that when the current, breakdown current, increases, the emitter to base junction is forward biased and will return in the previous case, with the current that does not go into the base but proceeds to the emitter. And asymptote of the characteristic in the voltage drive condition will still be BVC E0. In the end, we can say that whichever is the driving of the base, we need to consider this as a breakdown voltage. This region is only possible for very low leakage currents, and we can very seldom afford to work in this region. It is very dangerous, because as soon as you go above this leakage current, you snap back to this value, and there is a huge current flowing through the device.